Now, for the last few weeks on the show, we have just been sprinkling in some of you telling us stories about how you met a famous Pittsburgher in the wild and had an interaction with maybe a Pittsburgh athlete or just somebody famous from Pittsburgh, whether they were nice to you, mean to you, whether you had a funny interaction with them. Yesterday, some woman told a story how Troy Polamalu came over for dinner at her childhood home and drank one of those little huggy waters that, you know, kids usually drink. But hold on, let's get to this story.
Hey guys, it's Maddie. I've called before about my brother who plays volleyball at UCLA, but rewind to 2 years ago, we were moving him into UCLA. And
all right, so this is a California story here. This is Yinzers in the Wild story, West Coast edition. Okay. Here, okay?
We were at Home Goods, random Home Goods in California, getting him his dorm stuff and all of that. And all of a sudden, Abby Lee Miller comes strolling in, and I'm sitting there, and I've never met her in Pittsburgh before. And I was like, what are the odds that I've never met her, but I have met her at a random Home Goods in California.
All right.
Thanks, guys.
I love it. Just like random Home Goods in California. Who walks through the door? Abby Lee Miller, of course.
Dance Moms.
Famously
whatnot,
from here with the reality show Dance Moms. And you know, didn't Abby Lee Miller go to jail at one point?
Yeah,
and then she came
she
out.
Did.
Then
she
didn't
did.
She have some health issues for a while and everything?
I think so.
She had a lot going on in her life. Salute to Abby Lee Miller and all the dance moms. Because apparently even at Home Goods in California, you can have sort of a Yinzer in the wild sighting. I love that she had to go talk to her too. You got to, right?
Yeah, you see her. You got to.
I love how she's like,
Pittsburgh,
I never met you in Pittsburgh, but here we are at Home Goods in California. And it's Abby Lee Miller from Dance Moms. Let's get to this one.
Good morning, Mikey and Bob. It's your girl, Sarah. Heard you guys telling stories about people meeting Steelers players.
Yeah.
Good family friends of mine were at the Cheesecake Factory one day downtown.
Oh, man, we're at the Cheesecake Factory. Anything can happen.
Downtown.
Cheesecake Factory, downtown. Cheesecake Factory.
Southside Works.
That's kind of not really downtown, all right?
I mean, not technically, no.
Downtown. You still call it downtown? I don't feel like that. I don't feel like the Cheesecake Factory is downtown.
It's
I feel
still
like
a little downtown.
All right, well, maybe if you're from sort of out of town.
She's coming from out of town.
A mile away out of town. Maybe you drive in.
You're going downtown.
Southside Works is still downtown to you. All right. Rest of her message.
And their daughter was probably like 14 at the time.
I get hung up on the dumbest things.
She used the trash can, walked over to a trash can.
Oh, man. Walking over to the trash can at Cheesecake
Who's
Factory.
There?
Who's it going
to
be?
And there was a man standing in front of it, and she told him to move, to get out of the way.
All right. Hold on. This is a build-up here. Cheesecake Factory. She goes to throw something away. Way. Somebody is standing by the Cheesecake Factory trash that is
right.
A notable human being. Not only that, but she's now, I don't know, a little rude to the stranger, I guess, right? Get out of the
get
way.
Out of the way.
Get out of the way to the trash can? Who are you moving?
Use the trash can, and the man was Tom Hanks.
Oh,
she
my God.
She had no idea who he was. All right. Love you guys. Bye.
Send her to North Korea. What the hell?
Tom Hanks! Can't be mean to Tom Hanks.
Can't move Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks by the trash can at Cheesecake Factory. You can't move Tom Hanks. How do you not know who Tom Hanks is?
I mean, that might have been when he was in his Mr. Rogers zone, too. So he's, you know, if he's in character, he's super nice.
Yeah.
This little kid just comes out, get out of the way.
Yeah.
That's my trash can, Tom Hanks.
Yeah, he's definitely filmed some movies here, and he's been seen out and about, but Cheesecake Factory, by the trash can. Out of the way, Tom Hanks. Got to throw something away. All right, let's get to another story here.
Hey, guys. So my mom got to meet Dan Rooney while I was in high school.
Dude, I love these stories so much, man. Like, we have struck some sort of Yinzer nerve here. I love how
mom
these stories...
Mom got to meet Dan Rooney.
I love how these stories start, and then it's always... It's going to be the most mundane sort of interaction.
So my freshman year, we made it to the championship game, which is at Heinz Field, and my mom was the halftime announcer.
Oh, boy.
And her favorite memory is as she was going up into the box, Dan Rooney was there to meet her and offered her a donut. So, yeah, that... She told that story to everybody all the time. So, love you guys.
I love this city so much.
Then Dan was there. And he offered me a donut.
Dan Dan Rooney offered me a donut.
Claim the fame.
Here's what I love so much. When we speak these stories out loud, like all of you are listening, like, who cares? Dan Rooney offered a lady a donut who was in the like announcer booth for like a high school game at Heinz Field at the time, right?
And she has retold that story to hundreds of people.
Every single family gathering.
That's like what Danny gave me.
Who's making a run? Who's going to Dunkin', huh? Dan Rooney gave me donuts before. Offered me one. I didn't take it, though, because I got to watch my weight. I got a little potch going here. I wanted the Dan Rooney donuts so bad, but I'm watching.
I said, no thanks, Dan Rooney.
I got a sweet tooth, Dan potch. Rooney. Dan Rooney, if you start me with one donut, I'll find the rest and eat them.
I love these stories so much.
So do I.
Dan Rooney offered mom a donut. All right, Bob, let's continue some messages here of people that saw, you know, whether it's a famous Pittsburgh athlete or just a famous Yinzer out in the wild and had an interaction with someone.
Hey, guys, I keep forgetting to send this, but back in 2014 after the Penguins lost in the playoffs, me and a bunch of friends were down at Mario's in the south side. And
oh, boy, who's going to be there?
Those in the back of Mario's was Sid, Gino, Matt Niskanen, Holy Matta, James Neal. They were all back there.
All right, so we got a healthy amount of Penguins. We got Sid, Gino, back Mario's at the south side.
Matt Niskanen had a big goblet of beer, clinked it against my glass, and started chugging. So what do you do in that situation?
Chug, right?
You chug with Matt Niskanen.
Okay. See, like, that was probably so cool when it happened. And it's a story that you still tell to this day.
Chugging with Niskanen.
But when you say it out loud, I chugged a beer with Matt Niskanen, who's not even on the Penguins anymore. A mundane Penguins player that, you know, we won't really remember Matt Niskanen 20 years from now, right? But that story, though, was it with Sid? That's why I believe it.
What did he say? He had a big goblet?
A big goblet of beer.
Clinked it with me.
That's why I believe that story, though. Because it's not Sid. It's not Gino. I chugged a beer.
Niskanen.
At Mario's in the south side with Matt Niskanen. Hell yeah. All right. Hold on. We got a call here. Mikey and Bob, hello.
Hey, I have a Pittsburgh story.
All right. What do you got?
So whenever I was a kid, Woodson's down in not the strip district. It was down in the
Station Square?
Yeah, Woodson's down in Station Square. And he would run. I was probably 7-8 years old, and whenever I was down there, they would run a joke that kids would tell on KDKA every morning. Mm-hmm. Woodson was there himself, and he came up, and I was a young kid. He came up. I didn't have a joke, so he told me a joke to tell them.
Oh, man.
And so this was the joke. This was the joke that he told me. Said, what do you call a boomerang that doesn't come back? Mm-hmm. A stick. Get it?
Rod Woodson told you to say that on KDK.
Yes. Yeah. And they ran this every week for the next month. And it was like after KDKA would go to break, they would throw that on there.
Yeah.
And it was just my face on there as an 8-year-old kid telling Rod Woodson's joke.
You were a Yinzer child star, man.
You were, yeah.
Absolutely was.
Hold on, though. Do you still have video of you on KDK telling Rod Woodson's jokes somewhere? Do you still have it somewhere?
Somewhere locked in my mom's basement, somewhere in the piles of VHSs.
Yep.
There is a for sure, and then right after that it goes, Lebanon Church Road, Pittsburgh. They went right into that commercial.
Man, that's perfect. That's awesome. That's what we're looking for. Hey, thanks for sharing. You have a wonderful day, man. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. You have a great day.
I just love it. I chugged a beer with Matt Niskanen. An NFL Hall of Famer, former Steeler Rod Woodson, once told me a joke when I was 8 years old, and I repeated it on KDK. I love this damn city so much, man. Good morning, Mikey and Bob. Hello.
Hey, how you doing? I got one for you, seeing that Yinzer in Pittsburgh. My name is Phil.
How you doing, Phil? You doing all right today?
Yeah, I'm doing all right. Just driving to work.
All right. Now, who'd you see? Who'd you have an encounter with here, Phil?
Randy Grossman down Rivers Casino.
Phil, I don't know who that is.
Randy Grossman, a Pittsburgh Steeler.
Okay, is he like a 70s Steeler or something? Well, before my time, maybe. That's what it is, right?
Yep, he's a 70s Steelers.
All right, so it's you and Randy Grossman.
Standing there, he let me try on a Super Bowl ring.
Oh damn. Phil, there you go, man. There you go, Phil. Hell yeah. You got a picture with the Super Bowl ring on and everything?
No, I don't have a picture, but I got a picture of me and him.
Yeah, there you go, Phil, 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 Phil. It's good stuff, Phil. You have a wonderful day. We appreciate you listening, man.
All right.
Hi, Mikey and Big Bob. This is Sarah from Aetna.
Hi.
I have a Yinzer in the Wild story. A few years ago, I was at the Grove City Outlets. I went to Slippery Rock University, and I saw Big Bob in the wild.
Whoa! 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 He's right there!
Whoa!
You saw my guy right there! Whoa!
I believe it was the Nike store.
Nike Outlet, Bob? Yeah? Nike
Possible,
outlet?
Yeah.
Okay.
I was totally starstruck.
Wow.
Got a pic and everything.
Wow.
But I did miss you, Mikey.
Wow.
Talk to you later. Love you guys.
You remember taking a picture in the Nike Outlet, Bob? There you go.
I mean, I don't.
Probably, right?
It's possible.
Yeah. When you go. Yeah. There you go. Wow. Nice meeting of Bob there in the Nike Outlet at Grove City.
It was right. Either me or some really confused fat guy.
Just a big Rob out there. All right, let's get to another message here.
Hey, Mikey. Hey, Big Bob. I have a really funny Steelers in the Wild story. Right. So back whenever I was in grade school, it was fifth grade, Brett Kiesel came to Dormont Elementary.
Oh, man. Kiesel at Dormont Elementary. What an explosion of just Steeler Pittsburghness.
Dubbeard in Dormont.
I had the option to meet him during lunch or go play butt ball. I don't know if you ever heard of that game. It's like throwing a tennis ball at the wall.
All right, so hold on. Dormont Elementary, you got the option one day to meet Brett Kiesel at lunchtime. Or play butt ball. I feel like you got to meet Kiesel, right? I feel like that should be an
obvious
easy
choice. Yeah.
And my idiot self decided to go play butt ball instead of see Brett Kiesel, and I regret it ever since.
You should.
You really should.
Butt ball is always going to be there for you at Dormont Elementary.
The beard, though? The beard?
Once in a lifetime.
In Dormont?
Once in a lifetime, the beard coming to your elementary. And now you'll never meet Brett Kiesel. He just lives in the woods constantly.
Yeah.
He only comes out once a month to go to Gecko to get his supplies, and then he goes back. You'll never see Brett Kiesel again. He just lives in the woods now. He's a wilderness man, and he only comes out to go get stuff at Gecko, and
it's
then he goes right back to the woods.
It's the truth now.
Nobody's seen or heard from him since he retired.
Wow. Really blew it.
Good morning, Mikey and Bob. Hello.
Yo, Mikey and Bob. I just had to call in, man. You guys are making my morning, and I got a Yinzer story for you.
All right, here we go. Yinzer in the wild. Who did you see?
So this was circa 2018, the year after the Steelers drafted James Conner, and I was down in Southside. It's a Saturday night. It was February in 2018.
Yep.
The Steelers were done. It was James Conner and Juju Smith-Schuster hanging out, dancing on the dance floor with everybody. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, Pittsburgh royalty right there.
Yeah.
James Conner and Juju. I'm like, got to go say hi. As I'm walking over, I try to say hi to Juju, and he looks at me. He goes, hey, no pictures, man. No pictures, man.
Oh, no.
I said, I'm cool. I don't want to take a picture with you. That's okay. And then I tried to say what's up to him again, and he's like, seriously, man, you might need to go somewhere else. I said, no, I just wanted to let you know that I'd kick your ass in Fortnite.
Wow!
Got him!
Wow! The challenge, the gauntlet thrown down in the middle of the club! What'd he say?
And then he looked at me, he goes, all right, man, come with me real quick. We go over to the bar, he grabs literally a piece of paper from the bartender. He goes, write down your gamer tag. I'll play you this weekend. If you're not on at 10 p.m. on Tuesday night, then you're done.
Wow. Okay. So Juju takes you to the bar. You write down your gamer tag. Now, did you get on and did you play Fortnite against Juju?
Unfortunately, I did get on, but he did not.
Oh, no.
Man, ghosted by Juju on Fortnite.
And that's the end of the story.